It's nice to do that in person. Not that I didn't love seeing the bell. Hey, y'all. Welcome back. Feels good. So just kind of want to take in the moment. I was trying to remember the last time. March of 2019? 2020. And it was about, what, baby shower time?
And it was Margaret's birthday party.
Yeah.
Margaret's birthday party. That's not good. So, yeah, y'all make yourselves at home. I think if mostly keep our mask on, and especially when we're close to other people. On the back table, there's a place to sign in if we need to do any tracing. If anyone shows up with COVID in the next week or so, we might let everybody, we will let everyone know. Please don't hesitate. But you know what happens. So just everyone do your best and we'll go from there. Okay, I'm doing announcements today. So let me play around with this a minute. I'm going to try and do it without my glasses. Okay, on the back, we can still do the program rewards if you haven't done that. And a lot of you are fairly new in the group. At least in the last year and a half. You can go by, I guess you go online and sign up with your Kroger card, and then we get a percentage of whatever you spend at Kroger, they will kick back some money toward our church, and that's a really neat way for our church to get a little extra money. Okay, if you have your order of worship on the back page, please note our mask rules and regulations. All of you folks that are against mandates, guess what? They're here for your safety. So please mask up if you can. And yeah, Russ doesn't have to, and Buck doesn't have to. So life is good when you're that age. Christmas party is gonna be next Sunday night, 6 o'clock. Okay? You ever been to one of our parties? It's really fun. So come if you can bring a white elephant gift, you know, that's something that you have around your house that you don't necessarily need or want anymore. I personally prefer you don't bring, you know, junk that no one would want, but bring something that somebody might go, hey, that's an unusual CD or something. You know? But bring something that somebody might want to fight over, because we really like a good fight at Christmas. So, wrap it up and potluck. Bring your favorite dish or don't. We always have enough food. No one leaves any room that I am in hungry. So we will have plenty of food. And I will probably be wrapping up extra stuff for my house. Just so you know, if you don't bring a gift, you still might have to play. So forced festivities. That's what we have. Okay.
And special guests.
And a special guest is coming. And that's always good for pictures. So please come and be ready to enjoy the evening. 6 o'clock next Sunday, right here. What else, Bert? I feel like I got most everything there. I want to thank you all for putting on clothes this morning. And not just, you know, pajamas, but clothes. So it's going to be a weird Sunday morning, fortunately. But I like it. So let's worship.
We were abandoned by the family playground. They just have us. Today we light one candle, the candle called Hope, as a reminder that God's promises are true.
We place our hope in God.
We place our lives in God's care.
Come, all is ready. Let the light of this one candle call hope brightness to your spirits.
wife practices.
I was just about to say, Lauren, that was amazing, and I didn't know you could wail like that, so cool. My asthma is a little bit bad this morning, so bear with me here. Okay. I'm reading from the Gospel according to Luke chapter 21, verses 25 through 28. And 34 through 36 from the New Living Translation. As I read from this holy scripture, listen for God's word for you. And there will be strange signs in the sun, moon, and stars. And here on earth, the nations will be in turmoil, perplexed by the roaring seas and strange tides. People will be terrified at what they see coming upon the earth, for the powers in the heavens will be shaken. Then everyone will see the Son of Man coming on a cloud with power and great glory. So when all these things begin to happen, stand up and look up, for your salvation is near. Watch out. Don't let your hearts be dulled by carousing and drunkenness, and by the worries of this life. Don't let that day catch you unaware, like a trap, for that day will come upon everyone living on earth. Keep alert at all times, and pray that you might be strong enough to escape these coming horrors and stand before the Son of Man. This is the word of the Lord.
It is good. It is good to be here to see everybody. I want to thank, as Kathleen mentioned, I want to thank the vision team and our leadership for the past year and a half, who not only helped keep me safe, but kept things going. And we've, over the last year and a half, we've gained new members, even though we haven't been here in person, some of whom are with us this morning, and we've got some more visitors. And over the past year and a half, I gained a co-pastor. We had the opportunity to bring Sarah Harrington Jones on as a co-minister with me to do pastoral care through CBF Global and through Baptist Seminary of Kentucky. And that has made a world of difference for our fellowship. And she is very disappointed that she could not be here this morning. She's really looking forward to our first Sunday back. One of the biggest hits of 1965 was a prayer of sorts from, of all people, the Beatles. It was a song in which John Lennon cried out for help. Help me if you can, I'm feeling down. Help me get my feet back on the ground. Another of the biggest hits from 1965 was an apocalyptic vision of despair from Barry McGuire, who described the times they were living in over 50 years ago as the eve of destruction. The Eastern world, it is exploding, violence flaring, bullets loading. You're old enough to kill, but not for voting. You don't believe in war, but what's that gun you're toting? McGuire, 1965, McGuire inviting us all to look over to the events in Selma, Alabama. And he sang of astronauts going into space who then return to this same old place. And he pointed out how easily it is for us to hate our next door neighbor as long as we remember to say grace. And you tell me over and over again, my friend, you don't believe we're on the eve of destruction? Interestingly, as big of a hit as that was, and it was huge, Eve of Destruction, in 1965, it only got up to number 2 on the charts. And the song that kept it from hitting number 1 was the Beatles' Prayer for Help. Think about that. It was as if, as bad as the times were, we were longing, as much as we were longing to hear the truth of what we were seeing happening around in the world around us and all the horror that we were feeling, and we didn't want them to be overlooked or glossed over or ignored, as much as we longed to hear the truth being spoken to us and acknowledging this is what's going on, and acknowledging and hearing such things is important work for healing, at the end of the day, we longed even more deeply. And I suggest that with the help of knowing that there are others out there, help me if you can, there's others out there, we're asking for help, that when help comes, that when we know we're not alone, then we find hope that maybe if I know I'm not alone, that maybe we can get through this, hope that maybe, just maybe, as bad as things seem to be, this is not how it's all going to end. That maybe we're not on the eve of destruction. TJ just read for us our Advent scripture for today, our gospel text, which is for this Sunday, the Sunday of hope. The passage from Luke's gospel sounds sort of like Barry McGuire's song, doesn't it? It's known as an apocalyptic vision in our gospel, part of the apocalyptic literature in our scriptures. But contrary to how our apocalyptic literature in our scriptures, our Holy Bible, has been used for great cultural success and economic prosperity for some preachers, especially since the 1960s, the apocalyptic literature in the Bible is not meant to preach doom and gloom and to scare the literal hell out of you, nor is it to provide escape fantasies. While the world goes to hell in a handbasket and we wait for Jesus to come down like some sort of deus ex machina to swoop us away and take us away from all of it and let everyone else and the rest of the world suffer without mercy and burn without end. No, that's not what apocalyptic literature in the Holy Scriptures is about. Rather, The purpose of such literature in our Holy Scriptures is to name the things that are happening and then to instill hope in the listeners who are experiencing it. Not hope for escape, but hope to live through. To encourage perseverance through great suffering and tribulation, living through terrible injustices and unspeakable violences and unimaginable horrors into a new world here and now on the other side. Apocalyptic passages were gave listeners a broader vision to see beyond what was only happening around them, to see a different future breaking into their here and now. Apocalyptic messages boldly proclaimed that this world was not something to be escaping from. Not something to be escaping from. But instead, in this world, God's future kingdom was coming here and now, and it is something we are invited to be living into. On this first Sunday of Advent, the Sunday of Hope, biblical scholar Caroline Lewis asks, why Advent? Advent, she answers, is to help us see beyond our present. Why Advent? She says, to give us a lens. To give us a lens through which we see God at work where we can't see God at work when we don't have this lens. To see God at work when all that we tend to see is all the evil that is hogging the spotlight. Why Advent, she asks, to assure us that God has secured a future for us already that is breaking into this present and that really and yes, truly, changes can and will occur in our here and now. A Baptist pastor in Morocco, Reverend Karen Thomas Smith, says that this first Sunday of Advent is the time in which we are challenged to be honest enough to own up to what our lives and all that is going on around us are telling us about ourselves, about others, about our creation and our world. And sometimes when we own up to it, it does seem like we are bringing about our own evil destruction. But we are to own up to it, she says, and to own up to it and acknowledge it's not okay. But to do so without giving into despair. Advent, Karen Thomas Smith says, invites us to claim our redemption at hand. To prepare ourselves to receive it in this life and to challenge ourselves to get up and be a part. Advent invites us to claim our redemption at hand, to prepare ourselves to receive it here and now, and to challenge ourselves to get up and get busy being a part of that redemption. This morning, we are invited to acknowledge, as we already have through our prayers of the people, acknowledge the dangers, the sorrow, the threats, the injustices, and the pain in the world all around us and in our own hearts and in our lives. We are invited to name and own up to our doubts, our fears, and our own sense of helplessness. Sometimes, 50 years later, even today, it does feel like human destruction, doesn't it? Rumors of wars, real wars, murders, another surge coming up. in a new variant, COVID-19. So in a moment of silent reflection, I invite you, as all the weight of the world pushes our heads down in resignation, with our heads down, to go ahead and pray, and to pray for help. Don't let destruction have the last word. To pray for help, and in praying for help, to hear Jesus' voice assuring us and inviting us to lift up our heads. To lift up our heads, to stand up, to look about. As Jesus says in Luke, Jesus still says to us, lift up your heads and look around because good is still at work in the world. But just too distracted by all the bad. Find that good. Train our eyes to find the good at work. Look for it. Lift up your heads because grace is still very much at work in this world that seems so lacking of grace. Practice looking for and finding it all around you. Lift up your heads and live and love because life and love are also at work in this world. We're just so distracted by all the hatred and danger and darkness around us. Lift our eyes up and find life and love moving in the world. Get in the habit of looking for those things around you. And when you see them, when you see any and all of those things, then get up and commit to go out and commit to join in the goodness and the love and the grace and the life at work in this world. Get up and join in the Advent movement this season of hope and peace and joy and love, which are breaking into even the darkest of places and shining a great light into all the world. And maybe you'll find them shining the brightest light, even in the darkest corners of your soul. Take a moment of silent reflection and may this be so.
Down. Smile at me, come, come, come.